should we regulate profits? Some politicians say that a lot of corporations make too much money. They're charging ridiculous high prices while people go without. Well, what should we do about these immoral companies making profit? Should we cap corporate profit? Hint, we shouldn't. It's a bad idea. But also, video notes, they're in the description. So, we are in Desmos for another demo. So, in this example, we will try to regulate a natural monopoly by capping the amount of profit per unit they can make to a percentage. So remember that profits equal revenue minus cost. So by default, we're going to have a max legally allowed profit of 10%, and we're going to try to regulate by average cost. Why not try to regulate using marginal cost, as is normal in a competitive market? That's how prices are normally set in a competitive market. Now, many times the marginal cost is below the average cost. This is one of the criteria that can produce a non-competitive market. Thus, laws regulating by marginal cost could kill an industry by accident. We should also remember that regulating by average cost is also easier to calculate, and thus it reduces the cost of applying the regulation and ensures. So, we have our demand curve in red. We have our supply curve in blue. We have our average cost curve in orange, and we have our marginal revenue curve in green. So as we can see, we have the market normally as it is unregulated. So let's go to the government and let's switch on the regulation and see what happens to the market. As you can see, applying the regulation, the most you can charge for something is the average cost plus the regulated profit, or the demand or people's willingness to pay. This changes the marginal revenue curve and thus the optimal pricing for the firm. When average cost plus the legally allowed profit is below the demand curve, then it brings your marginal revenue curve down closer to your marginal cost curve. And so what it has done right here is it's brought our max profit point down closer to a competitive price point, and it's still given the company a decent amount of profit. So now that we have used these regulations, the firm has to respond to the new incentives of the law. We have to consider that costs are not unchanging. You can find ways to lower your fixed cost or reduce inefficiencies in your production, but it is usually easier to increase your costs than to decrease your costs. So what we're going to do is we're going to switch from our initial costs at the beginning to the ability to adjust our costs. So we can see right here is we have two additional sliders. We have a fixed cost slider and we have an inefficiency slider. For example, let's increase our costs a little bit and our inefficiency. So we have noticed is that by increasing our fixed costs and our inefficiency, the profit while regulated went up a bit, and the profit of being unregulated, well, that went down quite a lot. Now, normally, when you increase your costs and be more inefficient in producing something, it causes a reduction in profit. But here, your profit is based on the amount of cost you incur, so it actually increases your profit. And so let's just say that we want to become more efficient. We invest in ways to reduce costs. Well, our profit fell. So now that we have cut our costs, and become less inefficient in our production, what we have found is that we are making now less money. This is because we only make money on costs plus our markup. Normally, profit would be an incentive to cut costs and be more efficient, as you could then reap rewards in profit, but we've actually reversed it now. You're more incentivized to spend more and be wasteful, as opposed to find new ways to cut your costs. Since profit is the incentive for corporations to act, regulating profits fundamentally encourages corporations to behave poorly. Over time, this can lead to a large increase in wasted resources that could have been used for more productive things. Thus, this regulation is often harmful to society as a whole. So that is the case for what happens when we attempt to regulate profits by capping them, and why it leads to increased inefficiencies and reduction in social welfare over time. Thank you very much for watching. Hopefully I'll see you in the next video.